testimony that if you're having a conversation with, and, it's not a confidentiality conversation, because it's a conversation with officials, even if you represent them, or you represent them, you know, the general's office or whatever, if there's a conversation under the Eighth Amendment, the Maine
by the way, the answer is 12.
The Eighth says that all states are one. You don't agree with that.
No, because there are certain things where the right to privacy for
you're saying you have a right to privacy when you're having an individual conversation with that person who can't record you? Do you have a right to privacy right here?
That I don't. This is public.
But if we were in a room and I was recording you secretly, you'd prosecute, right?
I
you're trying to protect bureaucrats from being held accountable for their actions.
No, we're trying to protect the rights of the individuals that we've been dealing with who have a right of privacy. If the person I was dealing with...
This law, you must not understand what's going on here. This proposed bill would not make it legal to record conversations you're not a party to. It makes it legal to record conversations you are a party to. Did you understand that?
I don't want to get into a debate.
Do you understand it? I'm not trying to debate you. I'm asking you a question.
I'm not getting into it.
It's because you don't understand, or you just don't want to.
I think we have a different understanding.
Oh, well, so what is your understanding? I think you're a public official that likes to hide things from the public, and you don't want them to know what you're doing. That's basically
that's why they prosecute
from,
people.
Looking from the outside, and that's basically what you said. You don't want this bill to be introduced because you don't want the public to know what you're doing.
No, that's not what I said. That's not my intent.
If I'm on the phone,
gentlemen, at the
meeting. If I'm on the phone with you, can I be able to record that conversation without your knowledge?
No, without my knowledge.
Why?
Because under the wiretapping laws that exist now, you'd have to.
Because you got something to hide, right?
Recording. No, I don't. I
well, why not let someone record your conversation?
I mean, I would not have an objection to if you called me and said I wish to record the conversation.
Yeah, but I shouldn't have to tell you. Because then you might change how you behave, because obviously bureaucrats are pretty sleazy.
Is there any impact that the federal government is already recording conversations and it's known that they're surveilling people's private messages? I mean, is the New Hampshire state government going to be prosecuting federal officials for doing that to New Hampshire citizens?
What the federal government does is beyond. It's beyond my authority.
You should be ashamed of yourself.
I respect your opinion, but I disagree.
You're part of the public.
And what's your name, sir?
Public safety.
I'm Chris Casco. I'm the administrator of the Hearings Bureau at the Department of Safety. Okay, thank you,
Joe. I hope you find a conscience.
Well, hopefully someday you'll be able to. Sorry.
Well, I have a question about the attorney-client privilege. Do you believe that attorneys should be able to prohibit clients from being able to disseminate the information of what they speak about?
No, it's the client's privilege, so the client could waive it. The attorney can't, though. The attorney has to keep maintain the privilege.
Okay, so because it sounded like your testimony was insinuating that people should not have a right to disseminate or would not have the ability now to disseminate the information about what they speak with their attorneys, and I think... Well, I don't see why recording anybody would be a crime anyway. Why is it that don't you think that it would be better if people were able to record their conversations with attorneys?
I think the person could, because they're the one who has. If I'm the client and I'm speaking with you as my attorney, I could record that because it's my privilege as the client. But if I'm a government attorney meeting with a client, then if a third party could videotape that, then that would violate the privilege.
Okay. Do you know that this law, from my understanding, the new bill, does not in any way authorize third parties to do anything outside of a public space? Like, they still couldn't trespass into an office to record something.
Well, as it's written, I don't read it that way. I think it would give a third party an unlimited right to record.
Okay, because
you've misread the bill. I'll explain that to you again.
A city attorney. I've had a camera stolen because a city attorney has tried to prosecute me for wiretapping.
It's another meeting to get to.
There's lots of people that get prosecuted for this wiretapping thing, and I think it's totally not a crime. And it's every time. It's just because someone has a camera, like myself, like many of my friends. And I think it's something that needs to be stopped. Like, criminals are people that hurt people, not people who record in public.
No, I mean recording in public. No, the First Amendment protects that.
Or recording government officials. I mean, I've had cameras stolen from me because I've recorded in some government lawyer's office, allegedly. I mean, that's what they thought. They couldn't prove anything. But, I mean, how many people need to be harassed by police because they're recording? Like, it needs to be clear, and apparently, like, police don't understand it, so...
This proposal doesn't allow people to record conversations they're not a party to, so I don't think you fully understood the proposal that's on the table, with all due respect.
Okay, you're entitled to your opinion. Thank you, sir.